well.
Good evening. Good evening.
Hello.
Evening.
We haven't seen you since we got the news about Red McCombs. I don't know if we have an hour and a half for you to talk about what he meant to you and the city of San Antonio and
everything. Well, yeah, everybody knows who Red was and what he did. He gave me my first job. Been friends ever since. And he's been a mentor and a great supporter. So, all of us are feeling it to some degree, especially his family.
Greg, you're one of your young kids, Sohan, the kid from Baylor. What did you see?
The guy with the...
Yeah, but there's a part of the hair.
Yeah,
yeah. what did you see during the scouting process that drew you to him, and how do you look at his development so far?
You want just vanilla bullcrap, or you want the truth?
Well, truth is always...
I never watched him once. I don't watch anybody. It's not my job. I'm coaching.
Okay.
So you got all these guys you hired. I mean, all of us have, what do we have, 15 people out there scouting and 74 foreign guys scouting, and they watch him play, 12 games and 15 practices, and at the end of the season, I'm going to watch a film and say, I want that guy. Then what the hell are they all there for? I didn't watch one iota of any of that.
Well, how's he been to coach?
I had no clue. He just came in. Who are you? I'm the guy with the funny hair. What's your name? After a couple weeks, I remembered his name, and then you start going. That's the truth.
You get Trey Jones back tonight, or no?
Strange injury. He's one of the toughest young men on the planet, and there's nothing on film or anything like that, but it's just, he can't go with it. So it's tough for him, very frustrating.
Was there anything in particular you're missing not having him out there, just getting things organized? And...
Yeah, he's a point guard.
And you don't have any?
I mean, the other guys are 19, and they were in college a year, so yeah. It's going to take time for them.
The term load management came up very often in All-Star Weekend this past
week. Did it? Okay. I wasn't there.
What are your thoughts on load management?
We all do it. It's a long season, and everybody tries to protect their players so they can be healthy for the playoffs. It's just there. It's different. It wasn't like that in the past. But it is what it is now, and that's the deal.
How would you describe your experience coaching Kyrie when you had him with Team USA?
I never had him with Team USA.
You did?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I've never coached him.
Okay. Well, sums it up.
Pretty much. Just the facts, right? Who's that guy? Just the facts, ma'am. What was that show? Old people like me.
Dragnet.
Just the facts, ma'am. That's it.
I don't know how much you... watched the Mavs since Irving joined.
What's your guess, though?
Well, you said you do coach, so I would assume that
that
involves preparation.
We have way more important things to do with our group than watching Kyrie or Luka or anybody else. They're, it's their second year in college. So we're working on different things. And last time I checked, there's going to be pick and roll tonight. You probably... get back in transition defense is a good idea. Communicate a little bit. Block out. What the hell? We might as well block out. You try not to turn it over. You hope you make shots. What else is there? It ain't that difficult.
When Luke is on the floor, the transition defense is in this important.
For whom?
Where's Devin Vassell in his kind of comeback here? I think he's doing
I think they're expecting him to maybe be back by what do we have after Utah? He'll come home.
Indiana.
I think Indiana, they said he's got a decent chance to play then. And Jeremy, I He couldn't practice yesterday, but so I figured if he couldn't practice yesterday, how the hell is he going to play today? So I told him he's not playing. He's not happy. I don't care. Anybody else?
Hey, Pop, what stood out to you most about Zach Collins?
What's what?
Zach Collins, what stood out most to you about him?
He's got a little bit of a nasty streak that I like. You know, you got to be a little nasty, a little ugly at times. You got to feel that. And he's got that. He's got some good skills, and his progression this year has been wonderful. When you sit out for 2 years, that's almost an impossible thing to come back from. That's a long time. And it's taken him a while, but, you know, he can shoot threes. He's tough on the board. He handles criticism. He's a good team player. He's got a sense of humor. I love having him around.
You ever had a team with too many milk drinkers?
We've always had a lot of milk drinkers. But fortunately, that gets balanced by me. And I try to infuse that into some of them, and it works.
Pop, you're going into the Hall of Fame with Dirk in August. What are your thoughts on Dirk?
If you got to go in the Hall of Fame with Dirk, you're not worthy. He's worthy. I'm not. You know, Hall of Fame is for people like Dirk, not me.
You want to buy a palace?
I?
Well, your team.
That's a little more accurate. I was there. I was there during all five, but I didn't win them.
Now, Andrew, you, we're going to clear everybody out. We're going to do a little TV hit.
Sorry. It's been a joy.